fields of science, the fields of social, political, economic systems, hold the system you have, hold the state crafting you have. Who gave you? From where did you learn? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and four guided caliphates, they gave you. If you don't believe me, tell me, what was your civilization? What was your civilization at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Tell me. Dark ages. Europe was in dark ages. Italian Renaissance came from where? From which inspiration? Islamic Muslim Moorish of Spain learned so many things from them. Or was it your initiative? Show me from where. Then Protestant people, when they got bold, they got their own Anglican church. And then the Western churches with the Orthodox, they got clashes. You know that Henry IV and Pope Gregory VII, how did they did clash one another, the German emperor. And then after that, everything was separated. These people, go and see yourself how you people have it. Then what happened, this Patriarch of Constantinople? Why he got separated from the Western part? Because of all these things which you have, point of views. And all these starting of point of views that we should not have this system, we should not have this system. Who gave you? Who gave you the mouth of bringing justice? The Muslims, Spain, sir. That was the problem which you people faced it. Accept that. And these all things happening, we call it historical contemporaries. It was basically somehow connection to the liberty which Muslim gave to women, and Muslim gave, how many women you were having in those in the past? Tell me. You are trying to teach us that you are better and Islam is bringing all this bad? No. Muslims have become bad. I agree. But don't talk about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't talk about our Nabi. If you talk about him, then we will give you a sledgehammer. And you will take it, inshallah. So please, I'm telling again and again, for us in this dunya, nothing is greater than Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All the extraction of knowledge, exfoliation of knowledge in the West is Quran. I tell many times to the people that it is Quran which brought all these revolutions. Inner core. The inner core of the Western civilization is Quranic. Allah mentioned in the Quran all those things which you have made. Industrial revolution. All those things came in Islam. The scientific knowledge. But yes, when the Western people, they use industrial revolution, they did it in a different way. Injustice happened. That's why the books have been written. Adam Smith worrying about only few things and how to get rich and rich and rich. Then that's where socialism came. Das Kapital, Karl Marx. It is. Indeed, when the Europe came, broke their age of ignorance, there was a blast of knowledge. But I said, origin, where did it originate from? Originate Islam. Muslims of Spain, the universities of Cordoba, the University of Granada, talk about them. Why are you not talking about those universities? You know why? Because you know that once you open that box, all things will be solved. But you people don't want to educate, changing the names of Muslim scientists, even Hazem to Hazem, Gibraltar, Jablutari to Gibraltar. So nobody catches what's happened in the past, why these names are sound like this. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave the message to the whole world. Ana Muhammad, Ana Ahmad, La Nabiya Ba'di. I am the Ahmad, I am Muhammad. There's no prophet who be coming after me. You should listen to him. There is no salvation. All people are obliged to follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are the ummati, ghair ummati of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning which are depending on the message. And Muslims are the people who receive the message. And it's our duty to give to you. Islam provides social justice. For 300 years, humanity has been searching from east to west, west to east for social justice. Muhammad gave it already. And we didn't even give. These are not just sermons of beatitude of Jesus of Nazareth But this is in real, we did imply, we did show you through the teachings and through the actions of four guided caliphates. We showed to the world. Omar, what did Napoleon Bonaparte say? Sir, the French general, your French, who did Napoleonic wars, which was stopped at the Battle of Waterloo. You know that, all these histories. Don't be naive. What did he do? He said it. He said it, if this world produced two Umar ibn al-Khattab, there will be peace in the West and the East. This is what tribute get by, because they know these people. They were learned people. And French Revolution 1776 happened because of the kingship. They said, who is there better than? And then the taxes on, too much taxes on peasants and not on the noble classes. And the revolution came and brought into deadly revolution. And there's a time of terrorization. You talk about terrorists. You talk that Muslims are this. Talk about your terror era, where anybody who speak against something, chop him, kill him. Talk about guillotine. What are these guillotines business going in the past? Talk about that. So if you try to spit on the horizon, the spit will come back to you. You can never reach to the sublimity of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He's on the highest pinnacle. His stature, you can't even go to near to his stature. You're just wasting your time. It's better to change your policies and accept Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Accept as him, as he's the only teaching which should be successful in the Western civilization. No other teaching will stand, sir. I'm telling you, because if you read his teachings, unfortunately, look, Muslims failed to apply that. We agree. We are failed. But don't attack our Nabi. That's our concern. If we are bad, don't talk about our Nabi. Point to the bad people. So that's the only crux of the matter which I'm trying to tell you. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the best man ever lived on this world. He was a general. He was a Nabi. He was a prophet. He was a legislator. He was a good husband, good father. He was a commander in army. He was the highest in spirituality. He was the highest in the secular fields. He is doing everything. He is also the king. He is also the ruler. He is also like acting like a normal person. He is giving to the people the commands. Don't put your heart in this world. Imagine yourself that you are just a journey, as a traveler who's sitting in the shadow of a tree. You're just passing like this. Look at his teachings. And the going to the wars, he's commanding, do not cut the trees, don't kill animals, don't kill babies, don't kill children, don't touch women. Only kill the person, not even the old man, feeble, but only touch the person who's trying to catch you or who's just going to kill you, then hit him back. On the battlefield, he's giving these instructions. Who gave these instructions? Any general in the past history? Did Napoleon Bonaparte give it? Give it or not? Tell me. Did he give these kind of instructions on the battlefield? I dare know. It's the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. While victory to Fatah Makkah, when everything was under his hand, he forgave all the kuffar. And while he was going, there was a small animal, or I think so, a cat or a dog, puppy, on the way. And he said that don't go that way because the puppy is sitting. You have to just turn and make another way, telling to his disciples, don't crush it. Mumkin can get stampeded under your feet. Is that the person you're saying is a problem for you? I can quote you whole day night about the virtues of Prophet ﷺ, but the time is not there. You won't be able to comprehend. So I suggest the whole Franks, all the Western people, especially the France, go and read the seerah of Rasulullah ﷺ. Go and read the biography of Prophet ﷺ. Then you will be able to realize that nothing has been ever lived greater than this man. Even the Western people gave him tributes. And all those things he gave you. He gave you the just system. Fight back for your possessions and also give your right cheek if somebody slaps on the left one. Don't be all the time defiant. Don't be all the time hard on other person. He also avoid abeyance. That don't be abeyant all the time. Fight back for your rights. You have a complete right. You should have a tenacity of doing something. But everything has been given in some kind of particular orders and parameters in Islam. Islam is the controlled system in a social, political, economic, and it makes you to the better life of hygiene, in all things, sobriety, piety, and charity. We are the highest people on earth. I said, bring any candidate. You are helpless without Muslims' empire. You are helpless without Muslims' scientific pioneered knowledge. Don't try to tell us that you're better than us. Follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is a salvation. If you don't follow him, you are certainly going to hell. This is the message of Quran to the whole of the world. Follow him if you want to be salvaged and extricated. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.